Hi UiPath experts, so welcome to the UiPath.learner channel. So learner to expert, the concept is learner to expert. So here you can find interesting videos. So if you not yet subscribe UiPath.learner channel, you just type in YouTube UiPath.learner. Okay, so and subscribe. The first one is UL is UiPath.learner. Okay, subscribe it and share to your friends. Okay, so today I would like to show you one thing. So if you want to copy the whole thing Excel, the Excel sheet 1 to some other sheet, you can directly copy, right? So by using this, so I'm just using the Excel application scope or read range. It will read the range and store into the input data table, and write range will write the data table into the results sheet in the same Excel. Let's execute. This is normally we are using. Sometimes there is a requirement like so you want to change the sequence of the columns. So basically, so okay, sequence of the columns means now what we have a name is in first column, 0th index, age is a one index, location is a second index, right? So some people they will ask like age first column. See it written. Age in the, so I want age in the first column. Okay, age in the first column. How to change the order? Okay, let's go to Google and try to find a change order of columns in data table. So here you can find, so this is a thing, right? So this is a, they are saying code. So we have a data table. What is the data table? That is a input DT is a data table object. Okay. Of that columns of, so it is a square brackets because it is a C#.NET. In the VB.NET we have to use the normal brackets. What is that? Age, right? Age. Because we need to change the age into the first column. Okay, that is a index age. And this is a method, and which index we have to move. Okay, whether it is a index, it starts from the zero. Okay, so this is a method. Okay, so this is the argument. This zero is the argument. So, okay, here input DT. Input DT, that is our, right, input DT. This is a method. So what this method, whole method will do, it will not return anything. Okay, it will not return any value. So if it is returning any value, you can use directly assign operator, assign activity. So if it's not returning any value, so it is just doing something in the behind. So you have to use the method. There is a invoke method activity is there. Just drag the invoke method activity and so this is the right, this is the whole thing, object with the this one I copied and paste here. This is object and this is a method name. What method name you want to call, you want to perform, this is a method name and the value, the final thing is a value, right? A value is a zero, right? So just go to the properties of the invoke method. So in the invoke method there is a parameters. Just expand that one and click on the create argument. Here you can directly pass the zero. So what is that? This is an integer. So I'm removing this extra thing. Okay, zero at the position. Yeah. So that's it now. Yes, I'm doing the result DT, and this is also we have only. I'm saving. We have only one sheet. Just run it and see. So by doing this one only, you can, I mean, change the order of the sequence, order of the column names, the sequence of the column names. Okay. If you don't find anything such kind of things, you can just Google it by using the C#.NET like that. Then use the invoke method. Now see. See, age come in the starting, name in the, okay. So like that, we can change the column. So initially, what is it? Name is the first column, age is the second column. But here, the result is the age is the first column, name is the second column. In the memory, in the data table is a memory object, right? Object in the memory. So we change it by using this set ordinal. Okay, set ordinal is a method in the columns object. Okay, so thank you for watching. So if you not yet subscribe, please subscribe and share the videos. Thank you very much. Bye bye.